Kill the island, 1860, my dear and loving son John. Your good friend, the schoolmaster, Pat McNamara, so good as to write these words down. Your brothers have all gone to find work in England, the house is so empty and sad. Crop of potatoes is sorely infected, a third to half of them bad. Your sister Bridget and Patrick O'Donnell are going to get married in June. Your mother says not to work on the railroad and be sure to come on home soon. Kilkelly, Ireland, 1870, dear and loving son John. Hello to your missus and to your four children. May they grow healthy and strong. Michael has got in a wee bit of trouble, I guess that he never will learn. Cause of the dampness there's no turf to speak of, and now there's nothing to burn. Bridget is happy, you named a child for her, you know she's got six of her own. I say you found work, but you don't say what kind. When will you be coming home? Kilkelly Island, 1880, dear Michael and John, my sons. I'm sorry to give you the very sad news that your dear old mother passed on. We buried her down at the church in Kilkelly, your brothers and Bridget were there. You don't have to worry, she died very quickly. Remember her in your prayers. It's so good to hear that Michael's returning with money. He's sure to buy land, for the crop has been poor and the people are selling at any price that they can. Kilkelly Island, 1890, my dear and loving son John. I guess that I must be close on to 80, it's 30 years since you're gone. Because of all the money you've sent me, I'm still living out on my own. Michael has built himself a fine house and Bridget's daughters are grown. Thank you for sending your family picture, they're lovely young women and men. You say that you might even come for a visit, what joy to see you again. Kilkelly Island, 1892, my dear brother John. I'm sorry that I didn't write sooner to tell you that father passed on. He was living with Bridget, she says he was cheerful and healthy right down to the end. You should have seen him playing with the grandchildren of Pat McNamara, your friend. And we buried him alongside of mother down at the Kilkelly churchyard. He was a strong and feisty old man, considering his life was so hard. It's funny the way he kept talking about you, he called for you at the end. Oh, why don't you think about coming to visit? We'd love to see you again.